During a visit to the home of America's first president, a visit that's being called truly bizarre, President Trump had some criticism for George Washington and revealed his own ignorance about U.S. history. Brian Todd has been looking into all of this for us. Brian, what are you learning?
Well, this is a new account of the visit that occurred almost a year ago by the Trumps and the French president and his wife to Washington's home, Mount Vernon. The report says President Trump didn't show much awareness of or curiosity about the estate, but he was critical of it.
When he left the White House in Washington, D.C. last April with French President Emmanuel Macron to visit George Washington's home, Mount Vernon, President Trump flew past the Washington Monument, over the George Washington Parkway, and beside the George Washington Memorial in Alexandria, Virginia. And yet, once on the grounds of Washington's home, Trump apparently told the people around him, quote, "If he was smart, he would have put his name on it. You've got to put your name on stuff or no one remembers you." That's according to a stunning new story in Politico, which cites several sources briefed on Trump's comments.
It does tell you where the president's head is at. You know, this guy wants to stamp his name and likeness on everything, and he thinks Washington missed a chance to do that.
Politico describes Trump as being bored during that 45-minute tour, disinterested in learning about Washington and Mount Vernon, that it was a challenge for Mount Vernon's CEO and tour guide, who described the evening as, quote, "truly bizarre." And the guide, according to Politico, told others something embarrassing.
The CEO, Doug Bradburn, told people after that the Macrons knew much more about the history of the residence and American history than the Trumps.
The thing that got Trump most excited, according to Politico, was when he was told how rich Washington was. But Trump criticized the estate, Politico says, saying the rooms were too small, the staircases too narrow, the floors uneven, apparently ignoring the fact that the house was first built in 1734 and expanded in 1758.
This is just par for the course with Donald Trump. And speaking of par for the course, I think he probably feels Washington missed a point when he didn't build a golf course on the property at Mount Vernon, because that sure would have enhanced the real estate values.
Trump often seems astonished by history, often telling crowds that they should be surprised by basic stories from America's past.
A lot of people don't realize that Abraham Lincoln, the great Abraham Lincoln, was a Republican.
At one point, even suggesting Americans were only just now learning about Frederick Douglass, a former slave who became a famous abolitionist leader.
Frederick Douglass is an example of somebody who's done an amazing job and is being recognized more and more, I notice.
At his golf course in Northern Virginia, Trump even has a memorial to a Civil War battle at that spot, which historians say never happened. And unlike his predecessors, Trump isn't known for reading histories of other presidents, something historians say is worrisome.
Many other presidents have made a point of reading books about their predecessors and learning from their predecessors. And learning doesn't mean you have to blindly follow what your predecessors have done. You could, like Donald Trump, believe in shaking up the status quo, but you should do it from a position of knowledge.
The White House has not responded to CNN's request for comment on the president's behavior at Mount Vernon. But the Mount Vernon Ladies Association, which runs Mount Vernon, just moments ago issued a statement. The association does not deny any of the specific quotes in the Politico story. But it does say that during the tour, all parties were interested and engaged in the story of George Washington and his home. The Mount Vernon group says comments from sources who were not present don't properly convey the tone and the context in which they were delivered. Wolf?
All right, Brian, thank you very much. Brian Todd reporting.